Hello everyone, I'm very happy to be here with Bobby from Advantech. Hey.
Hi there, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. I know you've got some intelligent solutions of IoT and you've got the demonstration for us to just present it.
Okay, so.
I will give you the floor.
Right, brilliant, thank you. So what we have here is an NVIDIA Jetson platform.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now that's, it's good. It's kind of interesting, but you can also see that from many of our competitors out there. The Jetson platform is out there in the world. You can go to many different suppliers and find that platform, mm-hmm. that hardware solution.
Yeah.
And in and of itself, that's really cool for running things like the edge AI inferencing that we have here for to do object detection.
Mm-hmm.
However, where that kind of stops is that, yes, it's a great platform. It comes with its own BSP, board support package, so that you can get up and start running with it. But it doesn't do anything more than that. So you can get it up and running in the lab. You can do some clever modeling and you can detect products, or you could run, you could do machine learning, running data through it or whatever, and come up with some kind of solution. But that's all very siloed in itself. Where what we've done is a bit more interesting is that we have incorporated our own device management software solution into the Jetpack BSP, and indeed we've also run it on Intel Edge Inference solutions as well, where what we do is we deal with the device management of that edge piece, we deal with the connectivity to your back-end server, and then we can do all of the things like data management, device management, connectivity management, so that you can actually build a deliverable solution around
fully
the hardware.
Made.
Fully made. To some extent. We are not modeling experts. We don't go out there and design the models to detect your car, your person, your piece of fruit, your finished goods, your whatever. But actually what we do is deliver all of the infrastructure that you need between that edge piece of hardware that sits out there in the field and your server side. So what we have is the device here running the modeling. So we have our inference that's running here. And usually in any kind of edge AI solution, that's as far as you would get. If you then wanted to deliver that data back somewhere else, you would have to build your own solution to do that. Well, what we've done at Advantech is we've actually built that into the solution as well. So we're not only taking that data and it will now come up, it will take a few moments just to deliver through. But actually what we're running here is a dashboard. And this dashboard is actually connected into Azure, as you can see here in the URL. And actually we're delivering that data from the output from the model and delivering that back so that a dashboard could be built. So if you're thinking about some kind of solution where you're doing maybe video-based quality control, you've got your finished goods at the end of the production line, what you need is a pass or a fail on that. Well, of course, you could build a model solution around that. You could deliver that out into the onto your edge device. You could have your camera at the end of the production line, and you could then be
and
getting
the reading
that
is ready-made for me.
So you could really then get that pass or fail at the end and feed that data back into your manufacturing system so that you're collecting all your data, you're collecting your yield statistics for your production line and all those kinds of things. Not only that, because we're also able to then update that device, control the software that's running on it. When you change your finished good, so you build one SKU for a customer and then you want to maybe change the color of the label on it because another customer wants a different SKU, then actually what you can do is update the model remotely, deliver that model onto the device from your back end, from your server side, and then you've got your system is then ready to go again.
It's still tailored for the customer.
Yeah, so like rather than you having to send an engineer out to plug a USB stick in, deliver new software onto the device.
Saves time.
Saves service costs, all that kind of thing. So not only have we got this here, but actually what I've got is the dashboarding tool here, where what I'm doing is actually dialing into that device from my laptop, which is connected to another network. And I could be sitting here or I could be sitting the other side of the world and monitoring that device and actually gathering all of the information from that and updating it understanding if something is going wrong so that I can maybe remotely fix it.
It is all happening without your presence, without your being there.
That's it.
Right.
So we have this complete device connectivity management solution, device management solution, data management solution, all pre-built into the Jetson solution that gives you not just a piece of hardware that can run edge inference, but actually then deliver this whole story of a connected solution where all our customers need to do is to develop their own models to do whatever it is they need to do, to detect something, to analyze some data, whatever that is. We can do all of the heavy lifting of that data, the output from those inference models, and then deliver the results to somewhere else where you can then make decisions on what happens.
How about security of this data?
There's inherent security in the protocols that we use in delivering data, in the way that we authenticate devices onto the back end, how we then deal with security as far as access to those devices. So there's all of those are kind of built in to the system as well.
How about the interest of clients? Are they much into it? Because, you know, my idea of asking the question is how much the business trusts the concept.
I think it's still with edge AI. I mean, the funny thing about AI specifically is that we've been talking about it for many, many years.
Absolutely.
Intel, Microsoft were promoting and demonstrating smart mirrors for retail applications and smart advertising 15 years ago. But why haven't we seen that come out into the real world?
Yeah.
Because it's been around for a long time. My take on that is actually that the technology to do it has been there, but it's not been deliverable or scalable in any real way. We can build these models here to detect some fruit, but all it changes is a light bulb to go out and the model stops working. So you develop all of your solutions to do this inferencing in the lab. The data scientist gets all very excited because he's built this solution in this nice environment and it works.
Yeah.
However, when he takes that and unplugs it in his lab and goes and takes it and delivers it out in the field, it doesn't work. And that's because you haven't got this kind of feedback loop that you need to gather data back from the solution when it's in the field to do your kind of retraining, relearning.
Exactly, and then to understand what it provides for you.
And then to re-deliver your retrained models out to that device without you having to go and collect them, bring them back to the lab, do it again. And if you haven't got that ability to connect to and monitor and manage and update that edge device in that whole iterative process, you haven't got a deliverable solution.
So to make it work, it must be the whole package.
Exactly.
You cannot select.
No, you cannot just have that piece. You cannot just have the cloud piece. You cannot just have the edge piece. You have to have this completely iterative solution where you can learn, retrain, deploy, learn, retrain, deploy. And manage that solution.
As you are saying, it's been with us for some 15 years. Do you think people actually are starting to realize it?
I think they are. I think they're starting to, I mean, you look at all the kind of the video-based stuff that's going on now in security or facial recognition for understanding how people move. Even now, to the point where even the I'm not a robot box on your computer is actually run by an AI engine. It's not about whether you can click the box to say I'm not a robot.
Exactly.
It's about how they monitor how the mouse moves to click into that box. That's AI working in there to detect those things. So all of these small little implementations of AI are happening. They're becoming real. They're becoming, and so I think that's snowballing, and it's where we're then going to see these solutions being rolled out.
Actually, we have no other choice because when AI is working, I'm very often not aware of it.
Exactly.
It's working by itself. I'm not pushing any button. No. I'm not initiating it. It's already there for me and doing things for me.
It's ubiquitous. It's just in the background. It's just running underneath how our daily lives. And we'll start interacting with it more as solutions become deliverable and scalable. And I think that's where things like what we've done with Device On, where we integrate that solution into the hardware and the software packages that can deliver that edge inferencing, then starts making it a deliverable solution rather than just taking this siloed piece of hardware.
And not being able to use it fully.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much for this conversation.
Absolute
very
pleasure.
Educational. Pleasure,
Bobby.
Thank you.
Thank you.